we can't see you.
No, but you can see my hands.
Hands, we can see.
Korea,
doesn't matter if you can't see me.
Okay.
You follow the paper so you can make her model. Okay. I'll show myself later. Okay, now fold your square, the two opposite corners. Bring two opposite corners together.
8 by 8.
So we'll make a triangle.
8 by 8. Look at that.
Any questions? Just let me know. You can interrupt me.
Is it the 8 by 8 or the 4 by 4?
8 by 8. I'm sorry. Eight the green eight. Square.
The green square. If for some reason we don't have the 8 by 8, it's okay. Any other measurement square?
Yeah, any 6 inches, 8 inches, 7 inches, anything.
All right.
Preferably green color. If you don't have green, that is also fine. But that's why I said one square of green color, 8 by 8.
No, your instructions were very clear. But you know, end moment, if for some reason people couldn't procure, yeah, so just helping them.
No problem. So everyone is here?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, okay. Now after we have this, which is called, it's also called a nappy fold or a sandwich fold, is the name of the fold when we bring the two opposite corners of a square together. Now, do you see these two lines on the square? Is it okay? Now, this is the closed side. This is open. Now, I'm going to fold. This is the center. Okay, let's make one more fold. Once we do this, fold this triangle in half and open again. I start from the beginning. Opposite corners together. Fold this big triangle in half and open again, so we come to this stage. So we have a center crease, right? Now, once we have the center crease, this side which is open and this side which is closed, this has to come up to meet the center line like this. Okay? Same thing, this side comes up like this. So we get something which looks like a cone. Repeat the last step. We have this triangle. We have this side is open. This side is closed. Now I want this open side to come to the center side, but upwards like this. Is everyone here with me?
Yeah. Hitaji, just hold it up and also show them. Just hold it up and show them once, please.
I don't know why they... This, it looks like this. Okay. Now, the next step is we have to flip. Means, here you have this. Turn the model around. The back side. This is the back side. Okay, we were here where there were two flaps, two ears popping out. Now turn the model behind like this. This way. Turn the model on the back side. Okay. Now, can you see this? Now again, we have this side and this closed side. So what we need to do, I'm going to do is to fold this side to the center. But as I'm doing it, the back will flip in front like this. I put it on this here so you can see. So I want, when we are here at the back side, on this crease, this is your center line. This is your closed side. Closed side, I'm folding to the center. And as I'm doing it, the back flips in front. Same thing on the other side. So you will get a shape like this. So it looks like an arrow here. I think this thing is...
me?
One more.
Excuse me, we couldn't follow the last part.
This will be better.
Yeah, just a moment. We can't see clearly, you know. It's
clearly, please.
Yeah.
Now?
No.
Take it closer to you. Yes, this is perfect. Now we can take it.
This
is good.
This is better.
Yes, this
first time I'm trying this new device. So
no problem at all. Take your time and it's a beauty that you're making an effort. Yes.
Okay, we were here. Okay.
Just a moment. I just want to tell them, you all don't worry. If you all can't follow the instructions and be along with Geetaji, you know, we will be putting up this video on our website. And then at that point of time, you all can pause and see it and do accordingly. So don't get stressed and just enjoy it as much as you can. All right? Yes, Geetaji, you can continue.
One question. Everyone till here with me?
Yes.
Okay. Now turn the model. So you will get two triangles in front, top here, and a little edge here, and a cone like ice cream like shape. So I'm going to fold this closed side and this closed side to the center line. And as I do it, look carefully, this back will flip in front. Aisa ulta ho jayega. So this back will flip in front and we crease. So you'll get a little triangle shape like this. Again, this side, you fold it to the center, it flips in front, and this is the result. So it looks like an arrow. Is that clear? I'll repeat once again. I think I'll repeat from the beginning so people can catch up if they missed out. Right? This was our square.
Geetaji, is it possible for you to have a green paper without the markings? I think the markings are confusing than the creases.
No, do you have? If I don't do the markings, I don't know where to fold.
All right. Okay, no problem.
This is that line on which you fold. So this point to this point. So I'm creasing here. So you got a triangle, right? Then what I did was the open side. The open side, I folded to the center this way, and this side I folded to the center this way. Then I flipped the model, and the closed side and these two sides I bring to the center, and as I bring it, it turns. The back side comes in front. Again, this side, when I turn it, the back side comes in front. So there we are. This is the model which we have finished with. So the front side looks like this arrow, and the back side looks like this. If I hold it up, it's more clear. Right? The one side is this, one side is this. Right? Okay. Next. Now take your 4-inch square, a small 4-inch square. Can I see your 4-inch square? Just hold it up. Now, if it is white on one side and colored on the other side, I want you to let the color face you. The color should face you. I'm taking an orange color. I again repeat, 4-inch square, 4-inch, the smaller square. So the color should face you. Now, when you face the color facing you, you fold the opposite sides together. Does anyone remember what this fold was called? Anyone remember this fold?
Nappy.
No, that was the first one in the triangle. This was a book fold. Remember? It was folding like a book. This was a book fold. So once we have the book fold, now look properly. I marked it so it's easy for you to see. So I'm starting. This is your closed side, right? This is your open side where we have folded. We have folded here. This is your closed side. There's nothing here. So on the closed side, starting, we have a rectangle. Fold the rectangle in half, mountain fold, and open again. fold the rectangle in half this way and open again and come to this level, right? Okay, so I'm taking a black background. Now, if you fold the rectangle in half, we have a center crease. I'm going to fold this closed side. This is very important, not the open side. The closed, which is double, this side here, I'm folding this side to meet the center line. On from this crease to this point, I'm folding it like this. So it becomes a triangle. Once again, I'm folding the closed side to the center line. From this center point to this corner, this is the crease I'm making, and folding and crease very sharply. So on one side you have a square, on one side you have a triangle. Clear? Now, turn the paper. Lift it up and turn it around.
David,
we are here. I'll wait. I'll repeat this last step, or I'll start from the beginning. We folded the square in half into a book fold. Then the closed side, remember, closed side. No, then we did folded this rectangle in half. So we got a center crease. That was two very simple creases. One, we folded the square in half, and then we folded the rectangle in half to get your center crease. Now, to the center crease, we need to make a fold from this top, the closed end, to bring it to the center crease. So your crease goes from this center to this point. So this is your one side. Now, turn the paper this way. Again, we repeat the same thing. We have now your triangle is on the left, your square is on the right. Again, bring the closed side to the center line. So we have a nice triangle with flap on one side and the other side. On both the sides, we have a flap. One side and the back side. Right? It looks like this. Now the next is very crucial. Pay attention. You hold. If you see like this, you hold the double, this one point here and here, and hold the other two sides here and pull out. I'm pulling out and I'm going to make a squash fold. So I'm pulling out the portions inside and making a squash fold. So we get a preliminary base. It's called a square base. I'll say the last point, I'll do it again. We were here. Now, if you see properly, if you hold your triangle like this, you have one flap, second flap, single. Again, this is double, this is single. You hold with both your hands and pull out. Pull out, right as far as it will go, and bring all these four points together. And got it. Right? So there we are. Now, two more steps. Can I continue? Can I have an answer? Yes or no?
Yes.
Yes, I can continue. Now, look again. This is a square. I've called it the preliminary base. What is it called? A preliminary base. Now, if you see, we have four flaps. One, two, three, and four. Right? You have four flaps. Can you see the paper properly? I just want to know. Yes?
Yes, we can see properly.
So now this is a closed edge and this is the open edge. Remember, closed edge, closed. It is double here and not single paper here. So the closed edge, I'm going to fold. We have a center line. Fold it to the center and crease sharply. Right? The other side also, only the top layer, please, don't fold both together, only the top layer to the center, this side also top layer to the center. So we have a nice ice cream cone shape on one side and a little square behind. Again, once again, closed side. I'm repeating because many people fold this way. No, we want the closed side to the, so starting from the bottom here, closed side to the center, closed side to the center. Now flip your model. When I say flip, it means turn it around on the back side. Do the same thing here. The closed side to the center and this side to the center. And we are done. Now, this please crease very, very sharply. If you like, take a spoon and crease. Right? Now, from here, the last step is I'm holding the bottom. And I'm bringing this bottom point to meet the top point here. Can you see? I'm holding the bottom, lifting the bottom and bringing it here and making a nice sharp crease. Right? Nice sharp crease and unfold. So what did I do? I lifted the bottom, I put it to the top and I made a crease and I unfold. Now using your thumb and finger, I'm holding the center point here. I'm holding the center point here. And if you see, we have four flaps here. You see, it's all open here. So I'm lifting one flap and pulling it down. I'm pulling it down and with my fingers, I'm pressing all the other squares down to make a nice, pretty flower. Once again, we are here. I'm holding it at the center point where we made a crease just now. Lifting up one petal and bringing it down as far. Keep this hold. Don't let go of this hold. One petal, bringing it far down as I can. And with my other fingers, I'm pressing in the center of the flower and pushing all the other flaps down. So we have your flower. Now, we had made a leaf. So we are going to insert the flower in the leaf like this.
Beautiful.
Okay. Now, the reason I said
was, oh, cute.
The size of the flower, shape of the size of the square for the flower is quarter that of the square. Okay. So that's why I said 8 inches and 4 inches.
4 inches.
If you take 6 inches, you take a 3-inch smaller square. If you take 10 inches, you take 5 inches. Quarter of the length of the square. Now, one more thing. This is a model where you can use to make a greeting card and stick it on. But if you want the model to stand, look what I'm doing. I'm going to fold this leaf. I'll just show you. I'm just folding the leaf in half. So it will stand like this.
Oh.
It can be a table model also.
Oh, cute.
See? I've taken a bigger square than my flower looks bigger because I've taken a larger square. I haven't taken the quarter size of that just for a demonstration. So it can stand. You can see this is the back side.
Very good.
I've folded it in half. Or you can fold it a little less, however you want, and make it a table model. Or you can leave it as it is and stick it on a greeting card. You can make lots and make a bouquet, and you can give it as a bouquet also. Remember this flower, it goes into this pocket here.
Okay.
No need of any glue.
Okay.
Okay. Right?
Very nice, very beautiful.
Can I see if anyone has made it? Can you hold it up? Can you put a gallery view so I can
see? Shama, Sandra, Rihanna, Raji.
I can't see. Can you put a gallery?
Can you spotlight them, Salih, so we can see them?
Shamim, see mine.
One sec. Huh?
Yeah, just spotlight so I can see them. I can only see my hand. I can't see anyone else's.
Ah, it's pretty to ladies.
Let's have a color
video. Tummy?
Yes.
Wow.
Wow.
Yes. Julia was very nice. Yeah. Very nice. But you took a white leaf, right?
Yeah. I didn't get
it. Looking beautiful.
Okay.
You have seen one Gita?
Jane, very nice.
Went off complete, yeah.
Yeah. Nice too. Rihanna. Raji, good.
Lovely. Anna auntie also love. Everybody has done a wonderful job.
Everyone has managed to
get the green paper. So
yes, green paper will, that's why I said one green and any other color.
Yeah, sorry.
Now, one more suggestion. You know, when you come to this stage, can you spotlight me?
Yes. You're on spotlight, yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Then what you can do is, you can take your scissors and give this, instead of a triangle, you can make it into a circular shape also.
Yeah.
That can give a different shape to the flower.
Yeah.
Or okay, you can cut zigzag and give it a zigzag shape. It will come, you know, with little triangles, so the flower will look little different.
Yeah.
Up to you to give shape to the flower.
Okay.
Now we have time, no?
Yes, we do have time.
Another big 8-inch square. Any color will do.
See her at all.
Sorry?
Jane, you have to see her hand. She's showing us how she's making it. You can't see her face.
Next one.
This kind of word.
Next model, again, start with a nappy fold. So fold opposite corners. Yes, fold opposite corners together to get a central line. Fold opposite corners together.
Madam, the color side or the other side? The color side?
Plain side.
The white should face you. The white side should face you. So can you see the paper now where I've drawn the lines? What I've done is center line. I'm going to fold the paper in half, triangle, nappy fold or sandwich fold and unfold. So we've got a nice crease in the center. Right? Now, next fold is, what we are learning is the kite base, K-I-T-E. Kite base means we fold one side of the square to this center and the adjacent side to the center, not the opposite. So does it look like a kite or ice cream cone base? Once again. Right? First we did a nappy fold. We opened up. We got a center crease. Then we fold two adjacent. Adjacent means next to each other. If I say this, that is opposite. I'm folding the adjacent side to the center. So this folds to the center and adjacent sides on this, this edge folds to the center. Right? Now we have to turn the model. So here we have a plain side. This is your plain side. Now again, I've marked the lines so you can see properly. This is your plain side. Remember to turn the paper. Now again, fold the long sides. This is the short side. Fold the long sides to the center. One and two. It's a very easy model. Right? The long sides. One and two, long sides to the center. Right? Okay. Now, I'm going to fold the model in half. Means I'm bringing, can you see this line here? This point reaches the top point. So you fold the model in half. Right? A valley fold. If I just refreshing your folds, fold the model in half. And then the tip of this here, this tip, fold to this point here where these two lines meet. Fold down. It can come a little down, no problem. This tip, fold it down till here.
Finish on the last one, please.
Yeah, okay. The last one. We came till here.
Yeah. Yeah.
Then we
yeah.
folded the model in half.
Okay.
And the tip here, can you see these points here? These points yeah. here. This is where this was your center. So bring this yeah. point down here. If it goes a little below, also it's fine.
Okay.
Right? Now the next yeah. step is we are going to fold this model in half backwards. Mountain fold. Fold in half behind. Fold in half behind. Like this. Fold in half. I'll repeat this. We came till here. Fold in half behind.
Something wrong.
Okay. Right? This is where we've got. Can you guess what it is? Anyone?
Swan.
Yes. Who guessed that? Okay. I said you must have done it before or something. Okay. Now what we are going to do is hold the
swan
here. Hold it here. Hold it here. And with your other hand, bring, hold this beak here. Lift it up.
Wow.
Lift it up.
How lovely.
To get about 60 degrees angle. This angle about 60 degrees. So what I did was, I lifted it up. Try to get this angle as, or you can whatever shape, where the neck you want. And crease this point here, fix it here, and for the beak, pull out this point, pull it out, and press it down. So you get your beak.
Wow.
So this is your swan.
And put one kala bindi for the eye.
And you know something, there are many ladies around.
Googly eye.
You googly eye, yes. What you can do is take your napkin if you have a nice dinner party. Starch your napkin and fold it like this. And you can put it as a dinner decoration.
Yeah, correct.
Yes. Anna, you can make your angle a little less.
Put the beak down, Anna.
No, not the beak. This.
The neck.
If you like this, a little more graceful. You pulled it too much. Pull it in
the neck part.
When you put here, pull it down.
Okay.
Yeah, pull it down.
Can you see? I can't see anything.
Huh?
I'll show it again.
Just give me a moment.
I'll show this point again. After this, we folded the model in half.
Just a moment.
Okay.
You can't see. Just give me a moment, please. I just spotlight her. Just give me a moment.
Ha, that's better, Hannah. Yes.
Yes.
You got it. Yes, it's better. Yeah, that's better. So let's see all your swans. Yes, this is
better. Whoa.
So you can take any color. I have picked white because the swan is normally white. Yes.
Yes.
Could everyone manage to fold it?
No.
Yes. Oh, that's a beautiful blue colored swan. That's a nice one.
Yeah.
Those who are can do a little more difficult fold, I'll show you the shaping of the beak. You know, this beak is very long. So if you want to shorten it, what I do is, I don't know if you can see. I can make a zigzag fold like this. Just watch me. I open it out in the center.
Okay.
I fold once inside, a little bit more, and a little bit outside.
Okay.
So this gives you me a little more shape to the
beak. Okay.
See?
Oh, yes. Sweet.
So I'll just show it once again. It's a long beak, right? So what we need to do is open the, a little in the center. Fold it down once.
Okay.
Fold it down once.
Twice, double.
Okay. And then again fold it out a little more. And fold it in half again. So that's your spot.
Wow.
As I said, you can do it with a stiff napkin also.
Yeah.
Yeah, for your center tables.
Yes,
center. For serviettes, yeah.
So you can make a big one and put it in the center.
Beautiful.
Do we have time for another model?
How long would that take, Gita?
How fast you can make it?
5 minutes? All right.
So 5 minutes. Make the preliminary place which you did for the flower. So with the white facing you, not the color facing you as we did for the flower, the white facing you. White facing you. So quickly I'll do the preliminary base. Fold in half. Then fold the closed side on one side. Turn the model. Again fold it down. Again. Open it.
Gita, just go slow, Gita.
I'll repeat it. I'm just doing
same process.
Same process. That's why I went first.
I cannot see a thing.
Jane, just check your video because all of us can see.
Nothing I can see, nothing. Anyway.
Jane, log off and log on.
Okay. Fold the model in half. Then again fold it in half so you get a center crease. Okay. Then fold one side to the center. The closed side to the center line, not the open side. Turn it round. Again, fold the closed side to the center line. For a triangle. And then holding the two center points. Open it up.
Open.
So we get it like this. Right? Now, all done? Till here.
Are you managing or you want a repeat?
Repeat.
Okay. Okay. Fold opposite sides together. Book fold. Then fold the rectangle in half to get a center crease. Unfold. Fold the closed line, closed side to the center point. From here till here, this crease. And crease. Remember to turn the model. Again, from here, the closed side to the center and crease. There we are. Now, in the center, we have hold the center points, one and two, and pull them out. Pull them out and squash. Right? Are we all still here?
Is everyone okay? Can Gita proceed?
Shall I proceed?
Yes.
Now, hold this cone, this point to the center line of the triangle. It's a little difficult. I don't know whether I'll finish it.
No problem. Take, how much time will take?
I think it will take about 10 minutes or more. So shall I keep it for next time?
Yeah, if it's going to take longer with them, so maybe it will be a tight
tight schedule, no?
Yeah. we do have time. I mean, as such, you know, 7, 6, 5, 6 minutes, I can say, because you know, they'll take time to understand and it could be a repeat.
Yes.
Yeah. So let's keep it for next time so they can enjoy it. Yeah, so they don't have to rush.
Yeah. So you can practice your preliminary fold and your flower and leaf.
Or they can keep it ready, you know? They could keep the preliminary flower.
Preliminary base, you can keep it ready. We can do 2-3 models from that.
Yeah. So you know what? We are going to upload it on our website.
Yes.
Everybody pay attention. So what you all can do? Keep that preliminary, you can, you know, pause and watch it. And then keep the base ready. Yes.
Yes.
So whenever we are having Geeta next time, the base is ready and we can proceed. So, you know, you can write it down. There's the base and keep it somewhere. Yeah.
What is it if you are having it next time? I don't know.
Absolutely. We love to have you. I'm sure all are enjoying it, Geeta.
Yes. Yes, of course.
Yes.
Yeah,
yes,
very nice.
Course.
Interesting.
Thank you.
All in
You're
one
so
voice.
Sweet. Yeah.
Sorry.
And nicely explained also.
One sec. Yeah, I just moved from spotlight over Geeta, there so we can.
Geeta, a request.
Yes.
The basic folds, if you can repeat every time, the mountain fold, the table, that other fold, that napkin fold, if you can just show us, you know, before we start the session.
Geeta, you can do it right now. Just give them the folds right now.
The folds, folds.
I'm writing sample.
I'll just take another paper.
Just show down the folds, okay? Yeah. She's showing you the book fold, the mountain fold.
My writing fold, origami, as I introduced last time, as a language, right? So now,
language.
Yes, in mathematics, we have numbers 1, 2, 3, 4.
Oh.
In any language, you have A, B, C, D, and the script. So origami is a language of folds. So if I fold like this.
Book fold.
Yes, but I'm folding together. So it's called a valley fold also.
Valley, valley.
Valley, it looks like a valley.
Okay.
If I fold it behind. It's a mountain.
All right. Yeah, just a moment, Geeta. See, we are recording this. So y'all don't worry. She may go a little fast in explaining the fold.
Right.
But y'all can look at the video and then make a note of the fold. So this is a valley fold.
Mountain fold.
If I turn fold it the other way around, it's called a mountain fold.
Mountain fold. Okay.
Now, if I fold the sides together, right? I'm taking a rectangle. But the same applies to a square also. If you fold opposite sides together, it's called a book fold. It's like a book. Can't go wrong. Okay. Now the next fold will be, suppose we have a center line. I fold the sides to the center. Now you tell me what this fold is.
Cupboard
fold. That's right. This was your
cupboard fold.
Cupboard fold.
You open the doors of the cupboards, yeah.
This was called a cupboard fold, right?
Yeah.
So book fold, I mean valley fold, mountain fold,
and
cupboard fold.
So four basic folds. Then we have various bases. Just now, as we said, we learned the preliminary base.
Okay.
And we also learned one more base, which we did for the swan. You remember that name? Who remembers? This base is
corn base
or ice cream cone base.
Ice cream cone base.
Ice cream, you will remember better.
Cone base.
The base, B-A-S-E base. Many bases. Cone base, then we did the preliminary base. There is a water bomb base.
Frog
base.
Oh my god.
There are thousands and, I don't know, millions of origami models. The Japanese expert has a credit of 50,000 models.
Thank you so much, Geeta.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Was it okay?
Thank you, Gita.
Yeah, very good. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Use this double device so you can follow better.
Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you. God bless.
Thank you. Yes, Gita.
Thank you.
We look forward to seeing you again soon.
So yes,
let me know a tentative date.
Definitely. We will let you know well in advance.
Yeah, let me know 10-15 days ago.
Absolutely. Okay. Yeah, have a great week.